Hi, my name's Wei, and I'm currently eating lunch at my workplace. I'm gonna treat myself a brick. Wanna know why my diet is so weird? Listen to my fascinating story and you'll find out. I used to be an ordinary kid who ate ordinary things. I only began experiencing weird urges after I turned 13. It was in the late 80s when my country, China, was rising from the ashes. My family was so poor we were constantly on the verge of starvation. So it shouldn't be surprising that I tried to eat things that had no nutritional value. I had no idea why other kids didn't do this. Later I learned that I had an eating disorder called Pica, which means craving non-food items. I tried eating wood several times, but I didn't really like it. My favorite non-food item to eat was bricks. My home province is Hainan, and there are a lot of bricks factories here. My family lived close to one of the factories, and it's still where I live now. I used to play with my friends next to the factory, so I could easily get as many bricks as I needed. I tried to keep my taste a secret until I invented a great way to make some money and also prank my friends. What I did was make a bet to eat half a brick for $10. My friends were astonished as they watched me literally devour the brick in 20 minutes. After each of them contributed $2, I was unbelievably rich for a teenager. Heck, I was richer than my dad. He worked right there at the factory and he made $50 a month. I guess it was a very useful disorder to have when the times were hard. I still exploit it to make some extra money by betting with strangers. They never believe me when I say I can eat a brick. My friends were really worried about me, and they even thought I would die. Obviously, I didn't. I became very popular at school, venerated even. They thought I was some kind of Superman who could do incredible stuff. Well, teenagers love to exaggerate things. Girls used to give me a wide berth before I was popular, but I had plenty of attention now. I could ask any girl out, and they usually agreed. To their delight, I often ate bricks during our dates. I'm not sure why so many girls found the sight of me chewing on a brick so attractive, but I certainly didn't complain. If I were a teenager right now, I would probably make a YouTube video to roll in money and international fame. Oh well, unfortunately, internet wasn't even invented back then. Even now, we have restricted internet with no access to most of the popular Western services, including YouTube. Anyway, I didn't enjoy going to school very much. 5 years later, as an adult, I had to apply for a job at the same brick factory. I was actually happy to work there with plenty of food literally at my feet. I could consume as many bricks as I wanted, whenever I wanted. At lunch break on my first day at my new job, everyone was gawking at me, snacking on a brick. My new co-workers wanted to know how I could sustain myself on bricks while staying healthy like a bull. Yes, it's surprising, but I'm perfectly fit and even my teeth are flawless. My stomach is also fine, which is a miracle, really. I must have developed some kind of resistance as my body adapted to consuming and digesting bricks. I ate them for lunch every day now. For breakfast and dinner, I have regular food. When I was 28, I got married, and our wedding cake looked like a pile of bricks. I didn't eat the cake, I ate actual bricks. I'm 45 now, and I have a 16-year-old son. And guess what? He eats bricks too! Either our condition is hereditary, or he just decided to try them after watching me eating bricks. I don't know. Recently, we took a vacation in Thailand, and I had a hard time without easy access to my lovely bricks. I saw so many brick buildings and construction sites, I could barely keep myself from taking a bite. But they were surrounded by fences and the streets were crowded, so I had to settle for gnawing at the wall in our hotel room. Luckily, nobody noticed the state of the wall behind our bed when I checked out, or it would have cost me a pretty penny. As for my son, when I sent him to his great-grandma for summer break, he ate an entire wall. You see, the wall was almost entirely covered by a huge painting, which concealed the damage. Imagine our surprise later when grandma died and we were preparing to sell the house. As we were cleaning up the place, we removed the painting to discover the ruined wall. My son confessed his crime and we had a good laugh over it. Regardless, he had to turn over all the pocket money he'd been saving for years. Since then, I bring home a brick every day just to keep my son from eating our house. I simply want to avoid the repeat of the situation with his great-grandma's house. My son doesn't even ask for sweets or any other treats but bricks. I don't know if it's good for his health, but it's definitely good for the family budget. Bricks are so cheap, I end up saving tons of money on his food. My son is already dreaming of working at the brick factory with me and my dad. I suppose that's his only career choice anyway, since he's not doing very well at school. My point is, our family is really lucky to live next to a brick factory, or we'd consume our own house. I heard some people with Pica actually had to resort to that. Going to the doctor seems pointless. As I said, I feel perfectly healthy. Evidently, a human body can adapt to anything. But that doesn't mean that you should go and try to eat a brick. I mean, you don't want to get addicted to it like me. I mean, what would you do then? So let's discuss my unusual condition in the comments. Do you think I should do something about it?
Do you guys want more episodes? Then press the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell. Want to see your own story? Then send them over to this email here.